also a series of 12 matches. Through loopholes in the contract, the match has been, or the series of matches has stretched out more than just 12 months. It is now stretched out over 4 years. And we are now at the 12th match, and it is for the World Championship of BCW. Now, Jess, what is more important to you here? The fact that this is a title defense, or that it is the final match in the series?
You know, K-Dog, a lot of people in this business talk about one thing, and that one thing is legacy, Shawn Army. That one thing is legacy, K-Dog. And when people mention the word legacy, they're going to mention this thing. Oh, yeah, well, I've held this thing 30, 40, maybe 50 times. Yeah, the title's important. But over the last 4 years, my brother and I have wrestled the greatest series of matches in wrestling history. And today, when we decide the outcome of that series in the ring, the importance of it cannot be underestimated.
This is the last match that you are legally obligated to wrestle. Will it be your last match ever?
You know, I've given a lot of thought to that, K-Dog. When I wanted to retire 4 years ago, it wasn't of my own choice, but of somebody who is having a bad influence on my life. She's gone now.
She's dead.
So even after this match, rest assured, you have not seen the last of the heavyweight champion of BCW. So hell no, I'm not retiring. I plan on raising some hell for the next 3, 4, however many years I'm here, and Shawn Anarchy better be prepared for it. I don't give a damn what his name is.
Is this the most important match in the history of backyard wrestling?
Is it? You tell me. Are 50,000 fans in the BCW arena wrong? Are we selling millions and millions on pay-per-view? Can that be argued with? I don't think so. Backyard Championship Wrestling will never reach a higher point than it will today when Jess steps into the ring to put the title on the line in series match 12 against Shawn Apollo. No, my friend, important. Word. On the hour, dig it, yeah!
We'll be right back with an interview with the challenger.
Trepidation is the word of the day, and enthusiasm is where I go. Elizabeth, down the aisle! Woo!
All right, we're here with... Are we on?
Yeah.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're here with the challenger, Shawn Apollo, taking on Jesse Army in the world title match. Coming up soon, live on pay-per-view order now. John, have you found it hard to live up to the expectations that the fans and the general public have for this match?
You know, it's been building up for 4 years, K-Dog, but... You see, I always live up to expectations. I will let no fan down, and most importantly, I won't let myself down. You see, tonight, it's about proving things to people and proving things to yourself, Jess. I'm going to prove a lot of things to you. Him, of course, myself.
All right, I ask this question to Jez, I'll ask it to you. Is this the most important match ever in backyard wrestling?
You know, this decides a lot of outcomes. It answers a lot of questions. Questions that we all have. Who's better? Can they really do it for the 12th time? Rock the house down. It will be rocked down. And I guarantee one thing. That's all I'm guaranteeing. But these fans won't leave without the money to it.
I guess the only other question left to ask is, why was there an even number of matches slated for the series?
Am I supposed to remember? You're the one who drew up the contract!
I believe I can feel that, guys. You see, originally the series was scheduled
to... Shut your mouth! Shut it! It doesn't matter! What you say, think, or why. There are 12 matches slated. What matters is your belt's on the line, Jess. And it's gonna be mine.
Coming up next on pay-per-view, the Jess versus Shawn Apollo.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to...
Name of the arena. Name of the arena.
BCW Arena in Grandin City, Florida. The following match is scheduled for best 2 out of 3 falls. It is for the BCW World Heavyweight Championship. And it is the final match in a 12-match, 4-year series between Shawn Army and Jesse Army.
1, 2,
making his way to the ring, hailing from Apollo Town, parts unknown, standing at 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 195 pounds, Shawn Apollo! His opponent, the reigning BCW World Heavyweight Champion. He hails from Grandin City, Florida, standing at 5 feet 11 inches, weighing in at 169 pounds. Jesse the Jet Army! Jesse Army, BKA The Jess, BCW World Heavyweight Champion. All right, folks, I am Kaylon Varnes, and I am here to do the commentary for this historic, unprecedented, ball-busting affair. Right. The match is 2 out of 3 falls. Tonight, we're going to see who's got the cojones. All right, folks, I guess we're ready to go here. Best, like I said, it's best 2 out of 3 falls. Virtually an Iron Man match. We're going to see. This truly will decide who is the better. Coming into this match, the series is tied. Or is it? It's tied at 6-6, including the... Well, then how is it the 12th match? There was a draw, right? It's 5-5-1. Right, the Jazz, he's outside the ring. He's feeling out Shawn Apollo.
Oh, yeah, baby!
Are you sure this angle is the best? Tell you what, I'll just
mess with a little bit here.
Yeah, I'm right. You were wrong. This is better. You don't even know what I'm talking about, but it doesn't matter because this is BCWL. Ding, ding, ding. And there's the bell, and it is on.
Hey, hey, whoa, whoa.
Whoa,
hey.
What's going on in there?
Hey.
What is, apparently the Jets was trying to call timeout there. I don't know what that was all about. Everybody knows that there's no timeouts in wrestling. What's this? Shawn Apollo keeps trying to grapple, but the Jets is playing pussy.
Get out of my hair, Jess.
What is going on? Shawn Apollo in hot pursuit now. The Jets takes a shot to the head. Shawn Apollo. Now the Jets with the right hand. Shawn Apollo comes back with his own right hands, and now they grapple. They are locked up in the corner. Apollo pushes Jess into the corner. And they lock up again. And he throws him down. And another lockup. Nice snap, or a hip toss. Hip toss. Now they lock up again. Shawn Apollo with a release hip toss. Then they lock up again. It's been all wrestling in the early moments. Nice takedown, drop kick. Oh, what's it? Oh, body slam. Pulls Apollo up. Well, and he's got him in a... Couldn't see from where I am, but it looked like a sleeper hold. Jess tries to drop the elbow, misses. Apollo goes for the splash and misses. Jess with a and it's just crazy in there, folks. Went for the back splash and nobody.
No.
Whoa.
Fuck you.
Oh, Shawn Apollo faked the handshake. Oh, snap mare. Had him in the headlock down. They're up. Oh, and another snap mare. The Jets apparently vulnerable to that move. Got him in a headlock. Oh, and the right hand to the face. To the face, do you believe it? The Jets not wanting to submit this early. Not wanting to give up that fall. He's up. Throwing the elbow into the midsection. Now pushes them into the ropes, not so much an Irish rip, whip, and a shoulder block, and a clothesline. Drops the knee right into the arm, and he drops the knee again. Interesting strategy by the Jets, and he rakes the eyes, do you believe it? Stands him up, going for the suplex. No, and it's a body slam. Shawn Apollo. The Jets with a headlock. Sleeper hold for a split second. And now the Jets pulling him up. Got him in that side headlock. Irish whip. Close, no, into a sleeper hold. Now Apollo picks him up. Oh. I wish I knew what that move was called, but I've seen it before, and so have you, so it doesn't really matter. One, two! Shawn Apollo went for the pin, but he only got a two count. A two count has to be the upper limit on counts in the early going, and now here's some right hands from Shawn Apollo. And a kick to the midsection. Two kicks. What's it gonna be now? Picks him up and a suplex. Nice vertical suplex. Apollo drops the knee. Brutal, devastating, and effective. Picked him up by the hair. European down cut. Now he's got him in the headlock. The Jet trying to force his way out of it, trying to get to the ropes. Now he's drawing energy. He's standing up. Apollo into the ropes. Jess ducks under the clothesline. And a flying right hand. Apollo down. Now the Jets in control. Into the corner, and he hits the post. And a bulldog. Excellent maneuver from the Jets. He's going for the pin. And it's just a two count. Apollo kicks out. A very effective bulldog by the Jets, or so it seems. Now he's got him in an Arabian spacecraft. Head scissors.
Boom!
And a big drop kick. The Jets goes down hard. Apollo with a brutal body slam. And the Jets is in trouble. Drops the leg. Folks, you got to respect these athletes in there. He goes for the cover. And the Jets kicks out. The Jets not ready to give up a fall just yet. Into the rope. Irish whip. And reverse.
Yeah, got him now. What the?
Swinging neck breaker by the Jets. Out of the Irish whip. That's gotta be tough for Apollo to immediately recover. Picked him up. And a backbreaker. The Jets pulling out the repertoire. Corkscrew shooting star moonsault plancha. And he's got him in the headlock, the chokehold, as it were. The big right hand. The Jets staying within the rules with the fist open. Now the Apollo reverses the Irish whip. Picks him up and a power slam. Brutal. Right into the center of the ring. You know, the Jets is feeling that. Apollo with a stomp. He's got him in a brutal arm lock, and the Jets turns him over with an arm drag, of course. And a hip toss. Or I guess technically that's an arm drag. And another arm drag takes him down. That's right, all those moves earlier that I called hip tosses were really an arm drag. He's got him in an arm lock.
I got him now, baby!
Is Apollo going to submit? He's right in the middle of the ring. Stand him up. Twist the arm! Apollo trying to slip out. He reverses it.
Oh, God!
Tried to drop the elbow. Bad move, because now it's a check. With an arm drag. Actually, you know, that was probably more like a hip. Well, that was that was an arm drag.
Come
now he's got him back in that arm lock.
Come on!
Apollo has to know where he is in the ring. He's right in the middle. Can he get to the rope? Can he force his way out of it? Now, the Jets picking him up. Into the ropes. Through the ropes, onto the apron. Apollo's going to be feeling that one. The Jets talking trash. And it looks like they're going outside the ring now. Double axe handle. The Jets just stomping away at a helpless Apollo on the floor. Now shot to the head. To
the table. Irish whip. Oh, God. Right to the head with the water bottle. Now they're going back into the ring, apparently. And Apollo has the water bottle.
One, two. Ah!
Into the ropes.
Oh!
Need a face.
Come on.
And a swinging neck breaker, the move of brutal choice in the early going. They both executed one. Now Apollo into that bad corner.
Oh,
drops the elbow with brutal efficiency. And terrible, and there goes the rope again. Apollo's gonna re-hook it. And he rolls him up.
What?
He's got the tights, but it didn't work. Huge clothesline. Now the Jess with a flailing arm drop covers it, and Apollo has the rope. Jess picked him up.
Jess twists
the arm. Belly to back suplex, and he holds it, and again the Jess has to be feeling that Apollo saying it's over.
Boston ankle crab.
He's going for the Boston ankle crab. This could be all for Jess in the first fall, and a right hand to the eyes for the Jess. Small package. And Apollo grabs the ropes quickly.
Yeah. No.
Into the ropes, Irish whip. Just misses the clothesline. Spine buster. Oh, the Jess claps the legs. Folks, can you believe that this is just the first fall? And these two men are giving it everything they got. Right hand to the face. Apollo seizing control with another brutal right hand. At least he's wearing gloves. And he punches him in the back. The small of the back, where Jess has suffered many injuries in the past. And a knee to the midsection. Apollo! Boy, I'm surprised Apollo got the worst of that move. It looked like he was the one that executed it. You never can tell in wrestling. Apollo went for that Harlem Heat move. Missed. Now with the cover.
One, two!
And Apollo gets the rope. The Jess has to be aware of where he is in the ring. Oh, and he's pounding away with the right hand. Oh, and he's got the Jess. Oh, he's grinding that debris into Apollo's eyes. What's it gonna be? Looks like he might have been trying a figure four. Apollo kicked him to the corner. Whoa.
Oh, here's a good kick.
Now Apollo drops the leg on the back of the head. Guillotine leg drop. Folks, you won't see wrestling action like this anywhere else. Believe me, it's worth the $59.95 that you paid for it. Army reversed the power bomb with a haircut. Well, really more like a head scissors, really.
Now the Jess kicks him.
Oh!
Oh! Inverted throat buster and inverted stunner. Very good by the Jess.
What's
it gonna
be?
Oh no! Oh God! Stun gun right across the throat. Apollo has to be incapacitated from that. The Jess has to go for the pin or the submission at this point. I don't know if Apollo's been more vulnerable during the entire match. Oh, what's this gonna be? Oh, he gets up! Oh, Apollo! Jeez! Slams him down. Folks, you will never see it. That was a... I don't even know what that was. A super face buster. Apollo pounds the back. Now a kick to the midsection. Rolls him up. A gag! Arabian face buster? Who cares? It was a brutal move. And he landed on his face. But you get the point. I'm only getting paid $300,000 a year to do this job. Rolls him up! Oh, and the Jazz kicks out. It's amazing, folks. The tide is just turning back and forth in this match. One man has control and then the other has control. Neither one can gain the upper hand long enough to get the pin or the submission to get that first fall.
Powerbomb!
Apollo calling for the powerbomb, right hand to the back. On the Jazz, puts him down. What's it going to be? Slingshot into the corner. Looks like Apollo hit the post. May have hit the ring spring. Apollo barely got the shoulder up.
Yeah.
The Jazz frustrated. Now what's it going to be? Jazz with a right hand. He reached so far back that time. He scraped his knuckles on the ropes. Irish whip, misses the clothesline, the Jazz comes back, over the top, and he rolls him up right into the rope. Not exactly good tactical wrestling by the Jazz, but spectacular nonetheless. And a big shoulder block. He got gored that time. That's what I was saying, folks, the tide turns. The Jazz looked like he had it with the sunset flip, but he screwed up the roll up, and now Apollo's coming back. Pounding the right hand to the face. Apollo, pulling him up now.
Pile driver!
He's making my job easy, folks.
Yeah?
He's going for the pile driver, but the Jazz blocked it. Right hand to the back. He's going for it. The Jazz blocks it. And a backdrop. And a one. Two on, then he rolls the Jets over.
Two,
and
three.
And he got the first fall. One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first fall has been awarded to Shawn Apollo. Apollo rolled him up after a series of pin attempts by both men. Now the Jazz is in a hole. This is shorter than a best of seven or best of five series. Once you're down one, that could be all. And now we are ready to begin the second fall. Big right hand, and now the Jazz comes back with his own big right hand, and they are trading blows. It's like a bar fight in there. I wouldn't be surprised to see a ball start breaking stools and bottles over each other's heads. And there goes the rope again. I don't know what the problem is. And he hits him with the turnbuckle. Folks, this could be all. The match could end right here. After the Jazz took two brutal blows with that ring spring. Now he stands the Jazz up. What's it going to be? And a backbreaker. Classic wrestling move. One that I know the name of.
Got him now.
Apollo! Apollo went for the big splash, but Jess got the knees up just as Apollo was smelling the victory.
He could feel it, but the Jazz blocked the move. Now the Jazz. Apollo with an elbow to the head. Irish whip. Jazz reverses it. Picks him up. Spine buster. Looked like Apollo may have hurt his injured arm. Or I should say aggravated. What is the Jazz going for? He's turning him over. It's a sharpshooter. He's got him in the sharpshooter. Apollo's trying to get out, but he can't. And the Jazz pulling back. He grabs the knee pad for leverage. I can't believe this. And Apollo grabs the rope and violently breaks the hold in the process.
What the hell? Figure Army!
Oh, and he's going for the figure Army. Wait, what? It's a figure four. I'm not going to call it that. And they're just rolling around in there now, trying to gain the upper hand. Oh, and he's got him in an ankle lock. The Jess, he's right there. I don't know if he knows where he is in the ring. He could grab the rope. But he can't reach it. And Apollo is just brutalizing the ankle. Look at the way he's got it rolled up. And now he locks the legs. I don't see how the Jeff can survive this. Now he's going for the rope. And he can't reach it. And he grabs it. Good for him, or Apollo might have broken his leg.
Get up.
Now Apollo with a serious upper hand. The Jazz. Apollo with a sliding drop kick to that injured leg. Folks, this could be all for the Jazz. The title reign could end here. The groin hyperextension. And again! Oh, no! Folks, if the Jess wins this match, it'll be one of the most courageous efforts in the history of wrestling. Backyard, amateur, pro, or otherwise. I don't even know what this move is! Texas Cloverleaf! Tinkerbell whispered in my ear, and now Apollo breaks the hold. Oh, and he just slams his head right into the mat. Very unceremonious. And Apollo, hearing it from the fans, breaks the eyes. And he kicks him through the ropes. Big right hand to the head. Oh, what's this? Oh, and he hits him with a huge post. My God. Where are they going now? Oh, looked like Apollo might have been going for the bulldog, which would have been crazy. But Darby reversed the move, and now he hits him with his own belt. Oh, what? Apollo's laid out on the table, folks. This could get ugly. He's going from the ring apron. All the way from the ring apron. That's got to be like 3 feet. Hits the splash. Now he lays him out again. Oh, and he's got the chair. He's not going to hit him with a chair. Oh, God. And Apollo moved. Lucky for him, or he would have been killed. Oh! Apollo slams the Jess's head right into the thing, into the chair. the Jess has popped up now. No, he's not just crazy. He's not just popped up. He's mad. He's out of his mind. Now they trade blows. He comes right toward our camera stand. The Jess and Apollo both on the outside. Oh, went for the flying body press. Apollo caught him. Oh, you know what's about to happen? Into the pause! Folks, the Jess is feeling that one. It gets dangerous on the outside of the ring. Every move has to succeed. If you want to win.
Come on, bitch, get up.
Oh, and he's got a huge bat. Look at the size of that thing. Right into the stomach, Guat Galagad! And across the back, the Jess is in serious jeopardy. Not just for not just his title is in trouble, but his what? Is also. Drops the knee across the throat. And the Jess kicks out and grabs the rope. Now think about it, once he kicks out, he doesn't have to grab the rope, so maybe that was just coincidental. And he kicks him in the back of the head. Apollo in firm control. And I'm gonna put the camera down.
No!
And he rakes the eyes across the rope. Folks, you won't see too many more completely inhumane, horribly violent, gory, death-related sequences in the history of wrestling.
No!
Groin splash. Oh, what's it gonna be?
No!
He's got, oh! Stun gun right across the throat. Army pulled that move on Apollo earlier.
Feel now, huh?
And now, he returns the favor. Folks, this is the longest in the match that one wrestler has gone on the defensive or offensive. And now Army, Irish Whip, misses the clothesline.
I got him.
Now he's got him in a... And had him in a sleeper hold. And now the Jet in a funky Nelson. And now he's... Damn. Folks. I just gotta tell you, I just am not too good at names of submission holds. But that's not important right now because Apollo could be in trouble of losing the second fall, and you know it's gotta go three falls. Neither one of these men is gonna let their careers go down the toilet in two falls. My bowels are moving. But back to action. Oh, he got him with the old major look. That hasn't succeeded since 1672. Ah, snap suplex. Now the Jets. Oh, nice move by Apollo. And he's got him in that brutal ankle lock. He's going after the same leg as before. This could be all for the Jets. Does he have the strength? And he grabs the rope. So that strength and endurance were irrelevant in that move. Jess's tights are coming down. Can he suffer anymore? Can we suffer anymore? What's it going to be? The Jess in trouble at the Apollo bottom, but he gets him with the elbows to the back of the head and a stunner. Hits him with that stone Jess stunner. Drops the elbow. Oh, what's it gonna be? Is he going for the Jess's elbow? Oh! Don't know what happened there. Looked like Apollo may have blocked it with a kick to the groin. I don't know if he made contact. He blocked it nonetheless. And he punched it there. Big right hand, and Apollo gaining the upper hand in the match again. Kick to the chest.
Go!
Folks, we only have 68 minutes left on the air. And this could go for a while. Scissor kick to the back of the head. Spinner-Rudy. For what that's worth.
No!
Oh, God! Cryonic Kaiser. No, cryonic. No, you know what? It doesn't matter. It was a hell of a kick. Now the Jets tried to hook the leg for some kind of suplex. Apollo turns it around. Jess into the corner. Kicks to the midsection. Sets him up. Oh, do you believe it? A perfect plex. And he got the second fall. Well, I guess I should call it a fisherman's suplex or a Hennigplex. That is what it was, right? And I give the thumbs up. I finally got one right. I can go home now. See you later. And they're laying in the middle of the rig. Only one fall remains. And as I said, there are only 66 minutes remaining on the air for this show. Can they get the match done in time? Now the Jets kicks it. What's he going for? He's going for that Jess elbow. No, he drops the leg right across the throat. And Apollo grabs the rope. We have seen so many rope breaks in this match that it's not even funny. You think in a match of this magnitude, of this import, this kind of import, that they would know where they are in the ring at all times and not attempt submissions and pins right on the apron. And Apollo misses the elbow drop. Sorry, folks, I wasn't looking. But you know what? You know what that move was. Now what is it? They're going outside the rig.
What the hell are you doing?
Oh! Hits him with the belt. That was freaking insane. Now what is Apollo doing? Searching for a weapon of some sort, we can almost certainly say, oh no, it's a Mendo stick. Yeah. Apollo's weapon of choice. Oh, right across. Actually, that was his good leg. Oh, misses with the Mendo stick. Oh, breaks it across his chest. The front of his body somewhere. Oh, he's got that fragment.
No!
Oh, he ran out! I can't believe what he's doing! He's breaking that fragment of the Mendo stick right across his throat! Fuck. Surprised Apollo isn't bleeding after that. Oh, and he hits him across the back of the head with a Mendo stick. Oh, right across that shin pad. That shows you how much force you get with those Mendo sticks. What's it gonna be? Figure foe! Oh, what is... What the... Thanks. I have no rooting interest in this match. Although, what he was getting at is that is one of the few submission holds. Now it's... Oh, and he hits me with a Mendo stick! It's the only submission hold that I can execute correctly. And even then, not all the time. Apollo, pounding away with the Mendo stick, now getting the right hand to the face. Oh, and the Jets pounds away, and he puts the figure four back on. Apollo trying to grab that fragment of the Mendo stick. I still can't believe that it broke so soon. Oh, and the Jets grabs the ropes for leverage. Where's the referee? And he's doing it again. He truly is the dirtiest player in BCW. Well, he was grabbing the top rope that time. How insane is that? Apollo pounding away at the injured left leg. Oh, and they roll over right onto the apron. They're both on the ropes now, so one of them has to break. Get it? See? Because, well, never mind. All right. What's it gonna be now? Oh, kicks the ropes at a big, huge groin shot. Oh, pounds away at the groin. Boy, the Jets really sold that one. And now, Apollo kicking away. Oh, they're growing out. Oh, shit.
Oh,
oh,
shit.
And Apollo kicks him hard and even broke another part of the window stick. Oh, no. You think he's going to return the favor? Pouncing away at the head. You know the Irish whip routine. Oh, spine buster. We've seen a lot of those. The Jazz claps his hands upside that guy's head. Or midsection. There's not much of a difference in BCW, is there? What's Apollo doing? He's going over there to the debris table. Oh, and he's got a huge... Hey, folks, that is a triple... Look at that. That is a... Well, it's a double Mendo stick. You heard me correctly. He's got two of them taped together, which is how they're supposed to be, I guess. I haven't been around in a while. Oh, no. Oh, God! And again! I don't believe this! Look at this! Apollo murdering the Jets! And again, and it breaks! He broke it across his back! What is going on? What does society come through and make you do this? There is not enough people pay money to watch it. But we're back to the match now. After I was possessed for a second. Anyway. Apollo going nuts with the Mendo sticking again. Apollo into the rope. Spread a big splash. This could be off. Apollo's just got to cap it off. Oh, what's it? Fireman's carry ram. And again. Folks, I'm sorry. I realized that what I just said didn't make any sense. But that's what happens when you speak without thinking. I was just doing token commentary there. But now I'm going to do my damnedest to tell you exactly what's happening in the ring. Big European elbow. And again. Irish whip. Reversed by the Jets. Misses the clothesline. And Shawn with a flying right hand. How many times have you seen that sequence in wrestling? Now Apollo, is he going outside the ring? Or is he just going halfway? No, he's going over. He's going over to the table. Gonna grab some debris. He's got that water bottle. And he takes a drink! My God! And now he's got the chair. Looks like he's piling everything he can get his hands on over there, and I think you know what that means. He's got to slam Jess all the way through to the ground, and we're going to have to go to the emergency room. Oh, and again, all the way from the apron. That has to be at least 3 feet away. What's it going to be? Picks him up and lays him on the table. Looks like there might be some broken glass on there or something. Who knows? Now he rolls him over. He could be getting ready to cut it. Sorry about the camera work, folks. I'm an idiot. Now he pounds away. But trust me, what happened is exactly what I said happened. Oh, he pounds him. And I'm standing in ants.
Oh, ow!
Apollo continuing to pound away. Drops the leg. And folks, with the Jess in that position, that could truly wind up being a guillotine leg drop. Oh, what's this gonna be? Oh no. Oh no.
I got him now, baby.
The Jess! With four shots to the nuts. Oh no! Into the post. Can you believe this? Is he gonna jump? And he hits it! Flying body press!
Yeah, baby!
Flying splash, excuse me. This is really the only difference is in the orientation, whether it's vertical or horizontal. Now the Jess going back up. Pounds the elbow into the back, kick to the shoulder, right hand to the face, and again.
Yeah, I got it now.
Elbow to the midsection again. Pounds the elbow. Oh no. Oh no. You gotta be kidding me. Picks him up, and a pile driver onto the table. Do you believe that?
I don't believe what I just saw.
And the Jess apparently is okay. Or as okay as you can be after something like that. And onto the ground, or the floor.
Bang, bang!
Apollo in full psycho mode. Flying elbow smash. You usually don't see that kind of kinds of aerial fireworks from Shawn Apollo. Now the Jess left in a daze. Apollo went over there and turned something over, and now
Come on.
Oh no. He's got Apollo. Apollo's got the Jess. And they reverse each other Irish whips onto that ladder over there. Don't know what that's doing in the middle of the arena. Oh, he's got a minnow stick into the bad leg. And again, right onto that shin guard. Apparently it still hurts. But I probably shouldn't even be mentioning the shin guards. And he violently jerks Apollo off of the ladder. Into the post again. And he collapses onto the ring apron. Could they be moving back into the ring, or is this just temporary? Jess dropping the leg repeatedly. I don't know how Apollo can recover from something like this.
This could be all.
And I know a lot of you out there might not think that your $60 was worth it, but you're all assholes. And amazing, the referee hesitated. I don't know what the hell just happened. I am as stunned as you are, folks. What could have been a good 5 or 6 count wound up being a 2.5 count when Apollo got the shoulder up.
Oh.
Damn, you used to do that move all the time in WCW. Side suplex?
Oh.
Couldn't be that simple. I don't know.
Yeah, baby!
The Jets! Smelling the victory. It's
Jelly! Right jaw!
Penetrating his nostrils.
Oh!
Oh! Nice kick from Apollo.
Oh!
Frog splash!
One, two!
And the Jet kicked out! Folks, alright, I know it might sound trite at this point, but I have never seen such endurance, such strength, such will to win. Sorry about that, folks. Oh, man. Inverted. One, inverted. Two. DDT. It may have been a regular DDT, but you know what? I don't care.
Brain starter, baby!
Said he was going for the Frankensteiner, but the Jets blocked the move. Oh, what's it going to be now? Turns him over! Boston Crab! Apollo picks him up! Oh, and another spine buster. Seen a lot of spine busters and swinging neck breakers in this match. Apollo got that ankle locked. Can't believe that the Jets haven't submitted at this point after all the damage that leg has taken. Apollo pounding it into the mat, and now he puts it out with even more leverage.
Come on!
Apollo not going to give up this hold, and he's right in the middle of the ring. If the Jets is going to get out of this hold, he's not going to be able to grab the ropes. He's going to have to push his way out of it. Or not. And he grabbed the rope. Apollo's holding the move. He's holding it. Apollo gave up finally. Where was the referee on that move? Where was the referee? Oh, he's good. What the hell was that? Spinning, inverted, reverse, over the top, backbreaker suplex. Or a spine buster. You know what, I don't care.
Yeah.
Elbows, to the head, the chest, into the rope. Kicks the midsection. Looks like he might have been going for a Jess stunner. An Apollo bottom.
One, two, three.
Oh no! Two and a half. Apollo can't believe it. He can't believe that he didn't get the three count. But the Jets is still out of it. It's still Apollo's match to win. Grabs a chair.
I have you now.
Oh, the Jeff kicks him with his bad leg. Amazing strength. He's got the chair. Oh, man. Hits him right in the head. Could this be all for Apollo? The Jeff is still a little dazed. He's got to be feeling the pain in that leg. He's taking a lot of punishment in that left leg. Ankle, knee, groin. What is the... Where in the world is the Jess? The Jess is running away from the ring. You better watch out or he could be counted out. What is going on? He just left. He left ringside. He just left. Folks, he could be counted out. I don't know what happened. Might have been running to get some morphine. Do you hear something? Oh no. What in the world is going on? He wanted me to move that thing, and he's driving it right up next to the rig. Do you believe this? This doesn't even make sense.
I've got him now!
Folks, he has lost his damn mind. Now what is it? Oh, no, you gotta be, no, there's no way. He's not, not even he is crazy enough to do this.
No!
And he missed! He missed! That could be all for the Jets! Oh, God! After all the theatrics, he missed. Gotta admit, though, having the truck at ringside makes everything a little more white trash. Hits him with a chair. I don't know how the Jets can win this after the kind of bump he took, jumping all the way from the top of the truck, and Apollo is beside himself. He can't believe the Jets would do something that idiotic. And frankly, I can't either, even though the Jets has jumped off the Empire State Building and executed a move. Luckily, he hit his opponent, or else he might have been killed.
Apollo, I'm gonna pile drive him on top of his truck.
He's gonna pile drive him on top of the truck, is what he said. And folks, I think we all know that that's not gonna work. But that doesn't mean Apollo is not gonna try it, apparently. Oh, and he hits the end of the truck. And Apollo is injured. And the Jets, not showing any mercy. I'm surprised the Jets can even walk after he missed that, whatever he was trying to do, off the top of the truck. And now they go back into the middle of the ring.
Oh, no.
Wow. DDT. I gotta tell you, folks. The Jess and Shawn Apollo have both been incredibly strong during this match, but I gotta give the edge to the Jess in strength. He's had that leg murdered, and now he's right back up doing stuff after he missed that move off the top of the truck. He covers him. Did he get it up in time? And there's no signal from the ref. It was a 2.5 count. The Jets can't believe it. He's going to hook the leg. Oh, and again, Apollo kicks out. Don't know what's going to happen now. I have no idea. Of course, my job isn't to tell you what's going to happen, it's to tell you what is happening. Now the Jess has him in that brutal hold, and I wish I knew what it was called, you know? You think that they would get somebody that actually knows the names of wrestling moves to do this job. But I'm the only guy who was available. So you're stuck with me. The Jess pulling a Stevie Wonder on him now. Yep, that's right, you've heard of the Willie Nelson move, and now it's the Stevie Wonder. Maybe that's half and full Nelson. So we'll call that a half wonder. Huh? How about that? Yeah. And now the Apollo picks him up. grabs him, Jess rolls him up. And Apollo kicks out. Rolls him up. Oh, and Apollo kicks out. Army pin. More like a suck-ass pin. No, but I'm not biased, folks. I just call it like I see it. Which means that everything is biased in my, toward my opinion. I don't even know what I'm talking about. How about that? What in the hell? Folks, I might be, blind, but it looked like Army was face down on that one. Of course, I'll be honest, I'm a little bit inside of a second, and it's all that. And he turns it over. And neither one can get a pin. This is insane. Folks, would you believe we are almost 40 minutes into this match? I think. No, wait, we are way more than that. We've been going well over an hour. Flips him down. What's he going for? He turns him over. It's a sharpshooter. Or Boston Crab. I don't even know what. It doesn't make a difference. No, and now he's working on the bad leg. I don't know how the Jets can take any more punishment. I don't know how he can stand any greater degree of pain in the injured left leg. But somehow, he's reaching for the rope. He's trying to make it, but he can't quite get there. Such he goes back. Apollo pulls him back to the center of the ring. Such a tragic occurrence. Tragic. Tragic! Tragic! The Jets refuses to give up. One of the Jets. This could be all. Could this be the end of Jess's title reign? That is a sweet truck.
Jess! Fucking unconscious! Jackhammer!
Once he looks said he's gonna jackhammer him. Oh, the Jets rolls him up! And Apollo kicks out! Oh! Huge kick! I'm sure it has a funky name. And again! You think Apollo has not succeeded with that move as a submission hold yet, but he must trust it because he keeps going back to it. And the Jets won't submit. He will not give up. And now he's trying to make his way to the ropes. And he, for some reason, he can't reach the ropes, although you can clearly see at home that his arms aren't even extended. And he's right there. And he gets pulled back to the center of the ring.
I'm gonna fucking break it!
Apollo! And he's tapping out! He's tapping out! And that's it! Shawn Apollo is the new champion! Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, and new Backyard Championship Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion, Shawn Apollo. folks, you will never see a more courageous display of endurance and strength and total will in wrestling. I'm speechless. I can't say a word. It's so loud in here, I can barely hear myself talk. Apollo grasping the belt. I gotta tell you, folks, that was a great end of the match because it wasn't gimmicky. I mean, it actually ended on a submission hold that was placed on an injured body part. How about that for real? And Apollo, he's overcome! He's got the belt. He is the world champion. And the Jess isn't. The Jess still laying in the middle of the ring.
Certain things I see.
You might have to get a medic down there. Now Apollo's celebrating. Maybe he'll steal the Jess's truck. And they're shaking hands at Rig, at the center of the ring, and the Jess raises a hand. Classic good guy ending to a match. And they embrace. You'll never see a better match in wrestling, folks. Now, hope we didn't catch that on camera, but we probably did. Apollo continues to celebrate at the ring, in the center of the ring. Hey, is the fade set on anything? So if I pause, it'll just cut off.
I can fix it.
Okay. As it fades out, I'll turn down the music. Never mind.
What did you think of the match?
The best match ever.
Okay, we're here with Jesse Army following one of the most amazing matches in the history of wrestling, even though the Jess was on the losing end. How do you... Even though you lost, Jess, how do you feel about the match overall?
I said coming in that it would be the most important backyard match of all time, and I don't think these fans are going to disagree with that. And you saw an hour of blood, sweat, tears, gore, pageantry, glitz, glamour, razzmatazz, shoe sales.
I've heard suck at that.
Shoe sales?
I'm not ashamed of myself. A lesser man would have quit a long time ago. I probably got 4 broken bones in my 1 broken leg.
Speaking of that leg, I'm surprised you can even stand up.
I can stand. Not only can I stand, I can do this now.
Oh my God!
Jesus Christ.
I can't take that up doing yoga. Well, Jess, there's only one more question. Are you still going to continue wrestling beyond this point?
Yes!
Incredible. All right.
right, we are here now with Shawn Apollo, the new BCW champion, beating Jess 2-1 in the match we just saw. Shawn, how does it feel to be world heavyweight champion?
Well, this is the goal of any wrestler who gets in the Backyard Championship Wrestling ring. It means you're number one. It means you're the best. It means you're the grand finale. It means you're the main event. That's what I proved today, that I am the main event. Jess, you had a great match. I'll say that. You are a great wrestler, and that may have been the greatest match I've ever had, and I'm proud of that. But Jess, as soon as you challenge me for a rematch, there is no past. Just that match. That one match that proves to people I answered a lot of questions tonight. I won series match 12. I won the series, Jess. Have you realized that? That means I'm better.
I don't know if there's anything I can add to that, folks.